أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نويت الأربعين، نويت الاعتكاف، نويت الخلوة، نويت العزلة، نويت الرياضة، نويت السلوك لله تعالى العظيم في هذا المسجد إن شاء الله. First, I would like to say that it is an honor for me to be here. Before we left yesterday morning, we spoke with Maulana Sheikh Nazim, may Allah give him long life, and we said that we are moving towards here. He said, send my salam to everyone. When Awliya Allah, they sent salam, they sent with it support and power. Their salam is not like our salam. It depends on their levels. A wali, there are 124,020
in Bilya,
and there are from first level up to 124,000 level of awliya, means there are 124,000 different levels. If we have a sheikh of first level, his salam will be according to the first level. If a wali from the second level, his salam will be the second level. If a wali from the last level, which is the highest level, 124,000, his salam comes from the heart of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam directly. So when in the time of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Sahaba, his companion, used to go in circles and come back to Prophet to say Assalamu alayka ya Rasulullah, for Prophet to send them back salam, and he say wa alaykum assalam. His salam is not like anyone's salam. His salam is a majestic salam, beauty salam, love salam, all kind of beautiful things comes with his salam, the salam of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So it is, yes, Awliya Allah, they inherit that secret from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, between many many other secrets, that every time you see the sheikh and you say salam, try to say salamu alaikum in order to get back his salam.
This is los santos heredaron ese secreto entre todos los secretos del profeta, la parte de entonces trata de cuando un maestro dice salamu alaikum, recibir el salam diciendo alaikum salam.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Holy Quran, salamun alaykum min rabbin rahim, salamun qawlam min rabbin rahim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, sending salam from a merciful creator. So means his salam is carrying mercy, and mercy means forgiveness.
Allah
Alhamdulillah, that salam from Maulana Sheikh Nazim, may Allah give him long life.
Gracias a Dios, ese salam, Maulana Sheikh Nazim, que no le guarda vida.
Reached everyone.
Alcanzó a todos.
In one moment when he said, send my salam to them, that salam reached everyone's hearts.
En un momento, cuando él dice, mande mi salam, en ese momento llega el salam a todos los corazones.
And everyone present here is a sign of that salam has reached his heart.
Y todos los presentes aquí es un signo de que ese salam llegó a los corazones.
Alhamdulillah, we arrived after many years of thinking about coming to Argentina, and was a little bit difficult. I'm here in front of you, not a sheikh. I'm not claiming. I'm like you, like me. We are all murids of Maulana Sheikh Nazim. I'm not here to say that I know more than you and I have to teach you. No, astaghfirullah. I am the lowest. We are not coming for anything except to see you, to have some good time with you, and we go back, inshallah. You are the seed in this country for that seed has a secret in it. Every seed has a secret. And that secret cannot come without planting it in the soil. Might be you have different seeds. You look at them, they are seeds. But you don't know what kind of fruit that seed is going to give. Even agriculture engineers, they don't know. They know that the seed, for example, for watermelon. But they cannot describe what kind of watermelon, what size, what is the sweetness, what is red or white or yellow. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put in that seed a secret that no one knows what the outcomes of it. You have the seeds for apples. You know this red, this is going to be red, this is going to be yellow, this one going to be this or that, but you don't know what is inside. Might be there are worms inside. Might be it is inside not tasty, not sour. Might be you cannot know the size of it, how big, how small. So every creation Allah created has a seed, and that seed carries the secret of creation, of that fruit or that human being.
Every seed,
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put a secret in it.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put a secret in it.
No one knows what is that secret. As also any other creation that Allah created, there is a seed of that secret inside, planted inside that creation. Means if it is a human being, or it is trees, or it is anything living, there is in it a secret that Allah has planted inside that person, or that tree, or that water, or that fish, or that animal, or anything alive must have a secret in it.
Y cualquier otra creación que la persona más tabla haya creado tiene que tener semilla dentro de ella, que tiene un secreto, que tiene una vida, que tiene una propia creación. Y Allah puso su secreto en él.
That's why every human being has a secret.
Tiene un secreto.
Not two can carry the same secret, impossible. Even twins, they look alike, but everyone has different personality, different secret in him, different spirituality in him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made this group carrying a secret that will be shown, not now, it will be shown in the future by going to be like stars shining in dark nights.
Será un secreto que en poco tiempo van a ser como estrellas en la noche.
Van
a mostrar el secreto en la
noche. And everyone of us, that secret always our Sheikh is looking at. And that's why when you are in front of him, he doesn't need to look at you, he needs to know about you when he looks at your secret. All information that he wants to know about you, look at your secret, at that seed that it is planted inside your heart. That's why we say that too much near the Sultan to be always near him is like someone near fire. Because we are coming to his presence with full of dunya issues or problems, and he is looking at our hearts and he is seeing what we have been done in the past and what we are doing in show what our reality is, because he hides it and he tries to clean it. And that's why to meditate and to look at the Shaykh through the heart is important. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we know all of you, I think, how many names he has, beautiful names and attributes?
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we know, ¿cuántos nombres y atributos tiene?
How many?
99.
This is what we know.
Eso es lo que sabemos.
But in reality, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has infinite number of names and attributes.
Porque Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tiene infinitos.
Every one of us is appearing under the manifestation of one name.
aparece bajo la manifestación de uno hombre.
And from one to one, the name differs. That's why ulama Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, the ulama of Tasawwuf, they say that there are not 199
names,
but there are many, 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 many different 99 names. What we know these 99 names, هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الرحمن الرحيم الملك القدوس السلام. These are 99. This is one of them. There are others also, infinite number. Every person exists with the light of that name, that it will be special for that person. That's why Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam prohibited backbiting. Because when you backbite someone, it goes to Allah and to His Prophet back. That's why we have to be very loving each other, working with each other, peaceful with each other, helping each other, to become a community that it is strong community in order to build up their spiritualities and put their egos down. There are many teachers around the world. One time I was asking Maulana Sheikh Nazim, may Allah give him long life, and I am asking him about meditation. And he said, oh my son, what kind of meditation you are speaking about? If we are going to speak about meditation, that some Indians, they do that is not going to take them anywhere. You might experience something and you feel that you have achieved something, but that only it comes to you because you are putting your first feet into the meditation, but you are not really opening the right door. That's why you feel something, because your feet is at that door. The door that they open to you in such kind of meditation are like plastic food. Only looks nice. But real meditation is the meditation that connects you with Allah and His Prophet ﷺ. Meditation that builds on Islam. If you avoid Islam from it, as if you are avoiding completely the taste of the fruit, giving them a plastic fruit.
es como si estuviera sacando el gusto a la fruta y que ahora se está haciendo plástico.
If you try to connect them with the reality of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the reality of paradise, then they will give you the key for that through your meditation. And that key, everyone is looking for it. Are you looking for the key to paradise? We are coming here for sure. We are coming together, and you are leaving your work, you are leaving your job. May I have no job, it's okay, but for you, you are doing your best, you are coming here. And avoiding 1 week or 10 days of your work for what? For one reason. That reason is to get that key that give us happiness dunya and akhirah.
And
that key cannot be given so easy. There is one wali, very known, very well famous, like 1,000 years ago, Sayyidina Ahmad al-Badawi. His name is Ahmad al-Badawi. He is a very big alim, Islamic Sharia, and very big Sufi. He was always in prayers, always what he is doing, he is either teaching people Sharia, teaching them how to follow the way of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And how to follow Islam. And in the same time he was teaching how to be Sufis.
Sufis
is, the definition of Sufi is to how to improve their moralities, their behaviors, their perfection, to be perfect individual in the community. So one day he was sitting in his zawiya or his dargah, and he was saying, Ya Rabbi, O my Lord, open for me your door. This I think what everyone wants. They want that Allah open for them his door. Ya Rabbi, open for me your door. Ya Rabbi, open for me your door. He is sitting and asking and requesting until he heard, until someone appeared there. Look at him and left. Then after 2 weeks or 3 weeks, he saw him in the street. He said to him, Oh Ahmad, do you want the key for that door of paradise? And he said, Yes, I like the key to enter in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's divine presence. He said, said, I have the key for you. What he answered? He's proud of himself. That's the problem. We must not be arrogant, we must not be proud. This is the disease of the ego. He said, I don't take the key from you. If Allah wants to give me the key, I will take it directly from him. I don't need you. So, okay, go. Take it. What was wrong if he would say, give me the key, I will take it? No, this is our diseases, this is our illnesses, is we are stubborn and proud of ourselves. Can I jump to another story? Which is a good here. Grand Sheikh, may Allah bless his soul, was going with Sheikh Abdul Wahab al-Salahi, one Sheikh also in Damascus. They are going, you know, at that time, long time ago, they didn't have cars. They had a horse and pulling a carriage, and they were sitting both of them there. Both of them sitting in that carriage and going to Sayyidina Muhyiddin ibn Arab Mosque. I don't know anyone visited Syria can know that mosque. It is a big wali mosque. And one person appeared like Abdul Rauf in the middle of the road, hold this horse and ask them a question. And he said a question not to Grand Sheikh but to the other one, Abdul Wahab al-Salahi. He said to him, who is your Sheikh? You are he, Sheikh Abdullah is your Sheikh or you are his Sheikh? And Abdul Wahab al-Salahi said, he is not my Sheikh and I am not his Sheikh. Immediately that person disappeared. That was one of awliyaullah that appears in the time of Mahdi alayhi salam. His name is Sayyidina Abdul Rauf al-Yamani. And Abdul Wahab al-Salahi, look, he didn't see him and said to the Sheikh, to Sheikh Mawlana Sheikh, Grand Sheikh, Sheikh Abdul Wahab al-Bahistani, where is he? Did that mean? He said, no, he's there. I'm seeing him. He said, well, how I cannot see him? He said, because he cannot smell your evil smell. What was wrong if you said, he is my Sheikh? You said he is not my Sheikh and I am not his Sheikh. What was wrong if you say Sheikh Abdullah was my Sheikh? That is arrogance. So awliyaullah, they run away from arrogant and proud people because they have a very bad smell in themselves. That's why we have always to be careful how to polish our ego, and that's why we are speaking about what can take us to the door of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ahmad al-Badawi said, I don't take the key except from the key maker. That's why he disappeared and left him with nothing. That's when he left him, and Sayyidina Ahmad al-Badawi knocking at the door, and he heard a voice, Ya Ahmad. He was knocking and saying, Ya Rabbi, open for me. And Allah said to him, Ya Ahmad, he heard a voice, Ya Ahmad, my key is with that wali that he came to you and refused. You go back, find him. Ahmad al-Badawi. That one, he left him for 6 months, and Ahmad al-Badawi crying. That is meditation. Crying, sitting by himself and connecting his heart with Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, asking that they will open back to for that wali to come and give him the key.
Yes, it's a wali in the social habit from the 3 years that disappeared from the shadow.
After 6 months, he appeared to him. He said, Ya Ahmad, do you want the key now?
He said, of
course. I like the key. And the key is with Sheikh Abdul Rauf. He said, oh, but now it's different. At the beginning, I came to you to give you the key free. Now we have to pay. He said, whatever I have, I give you of wealth. Whatever I have money, I'm ready to give you, but give me the key. Before it was for nothing, free. Now, Ahmad al-Badawi said, I give you everything, my money. But awliya Allah, they are not after money. Allah will send to them. He said, I don't need your money. I'm not coming to get your money for some, give you something, take something. No. Awliya Allah, when Allah wants to send to them, anyone on the street can come, a wali, another wali, put in his pocket and go. They don't care. He said, okay, what I have to give you then? I said, I want whatever your knowledge you have learned from everything you have learned. Through your ego, it was blended with egoism. I want that knowledge to be taken away from you. Until to make you know nothing. Even I will not make you to be able to read Fatiha. Now today they say people are sick. They get sick of when they forget completely. What you call it, Nurjan? Alzheimer? He made him Alzheimer. Knowing nothing. Forgetting everything, even his name. Awliya Allah, everything Awliya Allah they make, or they mean there is something in medical science that gives proof. He said, look into my eyes. So look to me. Pull it. Sheikh Abdullah, pull it. Looking into his eyes, and he pulled all knowledge out. He left him knowing nothing, not able to read Fatiha. Alzheimer. What's Nurjan? Alzheimer. Alzheimer. When someone has Alzheimer, no, doesn't know anything. He doesn't know who is himself even. Be careful. You want reality? You want knowledge? Be Alzheimer. They open for you. But what you want to make yourself, you know everything? Leave them alone. Nothing? Submission? You get everything. So still we need to know the door. The key for the door. So he left him 6 months. Not knowing anything except one thing. That he was reciting to be able to open that door of the Divine Presence. Children were running after him. Oh, our Mufti, Grand Mufti became crazy, Alzheimer. He doesn't know what to read, he doesn't know anything. So they begin to throw him with stones. But since he saw the wali and he knew what happened with him, he knows that now he is really on the way of paradise, reaching paradise, for that door to open, because now no more ego on him, because he is being beaten by the children. When the children beat you with stones, know that you have no anymore any kind of arrogance. It disappears. You know that? Alzheimer. When children will begin to follow you in the streets and beat you with the stones, that is, know that you are Alzheimer now, you will be reaching quickly to the door of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This comes by meditation. So I will leave it for next session to continue that and the door for the Divine Presence. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. May Allah bless us and support us. Bi hurmat al-Habib wa hurmat al-Fatiha. Amur Shah Sahba. He say, MashaAllah, what kind of sahba is this? Because his daughter is here, he's looking this way. Ali, where are Shaib? Sheikh Nurjan. I called him specially. I requested, he is very busy because he was supposed to travel to China, but I delayed that for him. I said to him, come with me here, inshallah, to do meditation sessions. So I don't know how you are going to blend in these meditation sessions, but you know what to do, Sheikh Nurjan. You close the door.
No sé cómo van a hacer para que estas sesiones de meditación entren en el programa, pero es que saben qué hacer, no sé cómo son. Pues cierran la puerta.
You close the main door, no one can go out. Keep them in. And do your meditation sessions with everyone. I might be sitting there in the garden because I know he feels shy when I'm here. But until they are ready for the meditation session, Ali will perform the hadra with them. Because hadra first, then meditation. And Hajja and Sajida and me will have some, and Omar will have some food because they didn't eat since last night. You ate. Yeah, because Ali is now fasting, so. One hour hadra. Yeah. You want? I sit. I don't mind. Hajja and Taja, they didn't eat. You want to do hadra? Okay, no problem. Yalla, bismillah. Where Abu Shaib? Where the tabla wal darbuka wal fork? وفي شو في تاني جبت معك؟ جيب العود وجيب الدربوكة. ساجد بتلعب على الدربوكة، أنت بتلعب على العود. شيخ عبد الرؤوف. يا لوار بس. بس إن آخرة. For آخرة he's boss. Since how many years I know you, Sheikh عبد الرؤوف? Huh?
21
years. And عبد المتين also I know him long time ago. 12 years. عبد المتين. Yeah, عبد المتين came many times to Michigan, 3-4 times. He was living there for some time, was studying. MashaAllah. From 2-3 people or 4, MashaAllah, big group now. We didn't continue the seeds. You remind me tomorrow, I have Alzheimer. Remind me of the seed. Remind me of the door. Because no mind. When you have no mind, it's more easy. Is that? Because a child, young one, no mind. They carry him, they pamper him, they powder him, and then they kiss him. Because young, no mind. If we go back young, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send to us awliya Allah, will send angel, will send jinn, mu'min jinn, to help, to clean us, to pamper us, to take care of us. Inshallah, narjullah, we are asking, Ya Rabb, يا ربي بجاه حبيبك المصطفى ورسولك المرتضى وبجاه أوليائك الكرام أن لا تدع لنا في مجلسنا هذا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا دينا إلا قضيته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا والآخرة إلا يسرتها يا رب العالمين. اللهم يسر أمورنا واقض ديوننا وفرج كروبنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم أمد بعمرنا لإدراك عصر صاحب الزمان سيدنا محمد المهدي عليه السلام، سيدنا عيسى عليه السلام، بمعية سيد الشيخ محمد ناظم الحقاني. May Allah make our life long. To see Mahdi alayhi salam. To see Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. With the company of our Sultan. Sayyid Sheikh Muhammad Nazim al-Haqqani. وبسر سورة الفاتحة. How many in Brazil? Brazil? MashaAllah. May Allah bless you.
Yeah,
أيها الأخوة.